It is almost 23 minutes past six and you're with Checkpoint on RNZ National. It's just under 1 hectare in size, captures the sun to produce electricity and floats on water. New Zealand's largest and only floating solar array has officially opened in Auckland's North Shore Rosedale wastewater treatment plant. It'll save $4.5 million in power a year as it's sourced from the sun and reduce carbon emissions by 145 tonnes a year. Reporter Louise Tanuth and cameraman Simon Rogers were there for its opening.
It's been done overseas, but it's a first for New Zealand. A floating solar array that was unveiled today. It was full sun in Rosedale, perfect conditions for the array that will use the sun to treat the water here. It'll provide 25% of the electricity needed to treat the wastewater, which is a process of aerating it by pumping oxygen through. Mayor Phil Goth was there for the unveiling. He says it's a huge move that'll reap benefits for the community and environment.
We have a zero carbon goal by 2050, and this is something, given the impact of global warming, that we really need to do in this country. So the biggest array in the country, the first one on water.
CEO of Watercare, Raveen Jadaram, says it's bringing Watercare closer to their goal for the Rosedale and Mangere plants 5 years earlier than expected.
So already, Rosedale wastewater treatment plant produces its own electricity using the biogas that is generated from the sewage. And we're doing about 65 to 70% of our needs using biogas. This solar array will produce about another 25% of our need. So combined with the biogas, that's around 95%. So that helps achieve our objective of being 100% electricity neutral at our Mangere wastewater treatment plant and at the Rosedale wastewater treatment plant.
The array was built by Vector PowerSmart over 4 months. First, 65 concrete anchors weighing 2.5 tonnes each were lowered into this pond before nearly 3,000 solar panels were floated into place. The array gives off enough electricity to power 200 homes a year. The array is a partnership between Watercare and Vector PowerSmart. Vector's General Manager Roger S. Simons says the detailed system required many stages to be built and installed.
We built the system in four quarters, just over here. Each quarter is made up of a series of rows and pontoons that are interconnected. And as we connected each row on land, we then drove them into the pond as each row got connected. Once the quarter was floated, we actually pulled that around via boat to the location. Now on the location there's about 60 ballast systems that have been GPS located, and each quarter comes together, and then each quarter is connected by a series of rows of walkways, which then gives it the stability to be able to walk on and for future servicing.
Raveen Jadaram says all going well, solar could become more of a reality.
So this was our trial. As part of our approach to innovation, we like to try things, and if it works, we want to do more. And this was in partnership with Vector PowerSmart, and it's worked out very well. So we want to do more because we have lots of access to water in our business, and we do use electricity. So we would want to put more solar arrays, more floating solar arrays, and beyond our own needs, so we can put some back into the grid. I would like to think that we would probably commit to another one within the next 6 months.
And as Auckland still battles a drought with water supply just over 23% lower than its usual levels, Mayor Phil Goth says the solar array is a catalyst for wastewater reaching a drinkable level.
This water behind is capable of being treated to drinking standards, and if it keeps refusing to rain, this could well be a source, realistically, of the ultimate in the circular economy, where we don't waste the wastewater, we treat it back to purity and we reuse it. And that's not science fiction, that's something that many cities are doing around the world and will do here.
Raveen Jadaram echoes this, but says the process is lengthy and complicated, so it's a way off.
For us here, there are a number of steps. One is we need the legislation and the regulations to allow that to happen. More importantly, we need to bring the community with us. And elsewhere in the world, it's been shown that it takes about a decade to have the conversation with the customers and the people so that they understand and have confidence that this treated water is okay. So I would say, in terms of legislation and getting that buy-in from the community, we're looking at least 10 years.
I tāmaki makaurau mō te hōtaka o te ahiahi nei, ko Louise Tanuth, aho.